Hello, this is Fiona Stolze, and I'm going to show you how to make a silk scarf using your microwave. So the first thing you do is soak your scarf in a mixture of vinegar and water, one part vinegar, two parts of water for about 15 minutes. And when that time's up, you're going to take it out, give it a good squeeze out, and have a plastic sheeting ready to do your work on, because it's going to get quite messy. And remember to put a pair of plastic gloves on, because otherwise your fingers are going to get rather messy from the dyes. Here we are then. I'm stretching pulling apart the silk scarf. As you can see, when it gets wet, it really, really sticks quite heavily. So you're going to have to take a couple of minutes and just gently tease the silk apart. You can see me now that I've got it teased apart, just start to sculpt the silk into a nice, easy pattern, pushing it together. This is a pattern you're going to be applying the dye to when you're finished. So here we go. I've picked two dyes. I've picked olive and copper, and I'm going to work with two shades of each, a light and a dark shade. So four different shades in total, and just try them out on a piece of kitchen roll to see the intensity. Next thing, you're going to have four brushes to work with. I'm starting to apply the light shade of copper, and leave plenty of white spaces in between because you are going to apply the other colours as you work. So just evenly apply it over the silk depending on how much you want on. And here I go with the second shade of copper, just gently adding it on. And now we come to the third shade, the olive, popping it in there in the spaces in between the coppers. Again, put as much on or as little on as you want. It's totally up to you how intense you want the final look to be. Okay, and when you're finished with third shade, move on to the next one. Here's me working now with the darker olive shade, and this is quite dark compared to the other one, so it's going to be quite intense on the finished scarf. So here I go, dabbing it all around, not forgetting the edges. If you don't want the edges to be white, make sure you have plenty of dye on there, keeping your work nice and wet. It's really important to keep your work soaking wet for the microwave, because if it's at all dry, it's going to singe, and that doesn't smell nice or look nice, believe me. So, keeping it nice and wet, here I go, adding the final touches with the olive to the scarf. Again, the dye will just seep down through the silk, so the way you've sculpted it will determine how the final pattern looks. Next thing is then you're going to take a glass bowl and gently push the scarf together, pop it in the glass bowl, and once you've done that, you're going to put a covering of cling film on there, or saran wrap if you're from Canada or the USA, and take a fork and prick a couple of holes in the top. You're going to take it away now, pop it in the microwave for 5 minutes on a medium-high heat. Remember to use the oven gloves because this is going to be quite hot. So bring it back now and pulling the cling film off very gently. Remember to put one of the oven gloves or the mats underneath the bowl so it doesn't burn the plastic sheeting. And here we go, proof of the pudding, pulling the silk scarf out. And you can see there's no dye going on my fingers. This is pure water, so this is not a messy part of the process. You can see the nice patterns. It's still very wet and difficult to see what the final thing will look like. But all you need to do now is just take it and hang it up somewhere to dry thoroughly, and then you can wash it under the tap, squeeze it out, and iron it. And this is what my final scarf looked like.